Hi friends, welcome back to React.js Zero to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about component lifecycle methods in React. In this video, I'm going to explain about useEffect hook. Let's start. useEffect is a React hook that allows us to perform side effects in our components. What are side effects in React? Side effects are not predictable. We perform a side effect when we need to reach outside of our React components to do something. Performing a side effect, however, will not give us a predictable result. Some of the common side effects are making a request to an API for data from your backend server, to interact with browser APIs, using unpredictable timing functions like setTimeout or setInterval. We can perform these side effects using useEffect hook. In the last video, we have seen about component did mount, component did update, and component will unmount in class components. Let's see how we can use the useEffect hook to replicate those scenarios in functional component. For that, I have created a new React application, and in that, I have created a new functional component called myUseEffect.js. And I have configured that in the app.js, and so we can see this. Okay, assume that we want to fetch some data from backend when our component is mounted. In class component, we did that in the component did mount lifecycle method. In functional component, we can do that here. And so, when I refresh the component, we can see the fetch is happening. But we have a problem. Let me create a button and update a state. Now we can see the fetch is happening when the component is mounted. But when I update the state, the fetch is going to happen again on every re-render. We may not need to call the fetch on every re-render. We may need to fetch only once when the component is mounted. To solve this, we can make use of useEffect hook. First, we need to import the useEffect hook. And then we can call the useEffect. This accepts two arguments. First one is a function. Inside that, we can execute our side effect. And the second argument is a dependency array, but it is optional. First, let me move this console log inside this function. And let me have an empty dependency array. Now, if I refresh, we can see the console log. But if I update, this will not be called again. If I have a console log in the increment function, you can understand better. So this is working similar to component did mount. But in case, if we miss to specify the optional dependency array, this will be called for every re-render. So we need to be little careful here. Okay, let me add the dependency array back, and now let me add this state as dependency. Now, whenever this dependency is changed, this will be called. This behaves like component did update. If I add one more state, we can understand. Let me also create one more button to change this state. Okay, let me clear this and refresh. Now we can see the first fetch console log is showing. If I click this button, as the app count is getting changed, this fetch console log is showing again. But if I click this button, we are not updating count this time. And so this is not called. Actually, we can have multiple dependencies. Let me add age also. Now if either of the state is updated, this will be invoked. So we have seen how we can achieve component did mount and component did update. Let's see how we can do component will unmount. For that, let me create a child function. in which let me have a state. Let me increase the state every 1 second using a setInterval function inside an useEffect. And let me show this count here. So in this component, let me introduce a new state and conditionally render this component based on this state. Let me also create 2 more buttons to update this state. So if I refresh this and click the show child button, we can see this child component. We can see the set interval is running. Let me unmount this child component. Now it is removed from the DOM, but the set interval is still running. If I put a console log, we can understand. So we need to stop that when we unmount this child component. Actually, if it is a class component, we can do this in the component will unmount. So here, how we can do that? Here also, we have an option. We can return a function, and inside that function, we can clear the interval. Like this. Now we can see, when we unmount the component, the interval is cleared. Hope you understood. For this concept also, we don't have a task. But soon, we'll be using useEffect in tasks from other concepts. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.